My apprehensions also concern the nature of the examples that I commented upon in my essay. These examples are not numerous. There are only about 10 comics pages that are reproduced. They are from French, Belgian, Swiss, Spanish, Argentinian, and American artists. They have been selected not with the intention to meet the requests of a predefined corpus, but because of their exemplary nature or pedagogical efficiency with regard to the theoretical questions I raised at one moment or another in my reflection. There are two reasons why the book does not include a single page of manga. First, because the pages reproduced and analyzed do not in any way pretend to constitute a sample that would stand for comic art in its diversity. That was not the idea. And second, because during the years when I worked on this essay, from 1994 to 1996, the presence of mangas on the French market was still very little, very marginal. Well, I wrote this Univers des Mangas in 91, it was published in 92, so I was aware of mangas and interested in mangas, but it was not the problem for me to introduce a manga page in this theoretical essay. I can imagine that my choice of examples will look foreign, if not exotic, for the Japanese audience in respect of its own culture of comics. I do hope it will not keep the potential readers away from reading a book that nevertheless tries to question the ninth art, as we call it, in its universal foundations. I don't know if you have the equivalent of this expression here, ninth art, for comics or mangas. Do you say that also? No. They say it in the United States now, but I think it comes originally from France. And everybody knows that the seventh art is the cinema, but nobody knows what the eighth art might be. Well, there are several options. My ambition while writing this essay was to provide a toolbox that everyone could use and that would help reaching a more sharper and precise approach of every singular work. The methodic, reasoned description of all the various units that are involved in the language of comics takes a very important place in the book. Maybe I have been too long on this preliminary matter, at the risk of letting people believe that this description was the very heart of each other. And the cognitive mechanism through which the reader constructs the meaning and uses the elements of information scattered in panels that are either adjacent or distant. I have absolutely no idea of the distance between my essay and the propositions that Japanese scholars might have made on similar questions. The popularity gained by the mangas on the French market has not extended to an interest for essays about the mangas written by the Japanese themselves. We do not know how you describe and analyze your own production, and what lines of reflection about comics you follow, since no academic work has been translated so far. It seems to me that it would be very beneficial for us all if some university press would take the initiative of an anthology in which important articles or fragments of books would be collected and translated into English for the whole Western world, in order to establish for the international community of scholars a sort of survey of the research about comics here in Japan. Such a collection would be very useful and an invaluable basis for future exchanges. The model for such a volume is the Comics Studies Reader that was edited this year by, I don't know how their work is, their name is supposed to be pronounced Jeet here and Kent Worcester at the University Press of Mississippi. This volume is described on the back cover as a survey of the best scholarly writing on the form, craft, history, and significance of the comics. The contributors are about 30. I have the honor to be one of them, but there is only one author representing Japan, namely Mrs. Fusami Ogi, or Oji? Ogi. And she teaches in Fukuoka at the university. Maybe she's here. There you are. How far do Western comics and mangas differ from each other? Do their respective singularity allow us to dream of a unified theory of comics as such? Or do they lead us to build different theories, to invent specific concepts? This question is still open, it seems, and I guess it will put many of us to work in the coming years. The historical situation that we are living, characterized by a massive spreading of the manga culture throughout the world. Some observers describe manga as the ferment of a new world pop culture. This situation is calling for a development of comparative studies. We are waiting for the emergence of comparative comics on the model of comparative literature. And as for me, I believe that this new discipline will encourage international exchanges between scholars and resource places like this museum. I have no intention to go to the root of this new field today, but I would like to share with you a very stimulating remark that I have heard from the mouth of my friend, the British scholar Paul Cravet, during a conference that was held earlier this year in Sweden. According to Cravet, in Western comics, we read what happens next. In mangas, we read what is happening right now. In other words, the narrative techniques and processes that are used in mangas give to the reader the feeling of being immersed in the action, whereas Western comics create a more distant relation between the reader and the narrative.